an emergency meeting of energy ministers, and they will probably decide emergency measures on a scale that had seemed totally unimaginable until quite recently. This will include a windfall tax on low-cost energy producers, including nuclear operators, renewable operators, and lignite operators. And it might also include a cap on wholesale electricity prices, some around 200 euros per megawatt hour. The aim of that is to still be a high enough price to deter consumption, so because Europe needs to reduce consumption to avoid a winter crisis, but also to give at least consumers and industry some form of security that prices won't spiral even further come the winter time. Yeah, Annette was absolutely correct in pointing out that this is really difficult. The EU member states have to agree. You have to put in reforms of the futures, the derivatives trading market that she also mentioned, into place. And of course, you need to still ensure gas supply. So, for instance, if, as planned, there was to be a price cap on Russian imports of natural gas, Russia has already implied and indicated that it might cut off the remaining gas that actually is still flowing to the EU. Now, for sure, Russia has already reduced its gas flows to the EU by about 90% versus this time last year. So there's not that much gas left, which is probably why they're willing to put a cap on it. But of course, there's other supplies as well. You'd have to still hope that you can import natural gas imports via liquefied natural gas, so via tanker. And if that price isn't high enough, it just doesn't come to Europe. So introducing a price cap is a very, very risky business. And this is why regulators and energy ministers are trying to find sort of this thin red line to find a price that is high enough to ensure to attract imports of alternative supply, especially of LNG, while also deterring consumption, because we need to get reduce consumption this winter in order to ensure supply. But also to reduce the price shock of these high prices. And that is a very, very complicated matter. And not every EU member state has the same idea of how to get there. That said, we do think there is consensus emerging slowly. And the EU, despite all the different views of its 27 member states over the past crises, has normally managed to come out with last-minute compromises that serve everyone. So we're cautiously optimistic that some form of a solution will happen.